in order to save himself was not hard to imagine. So the angel comes to Joseph with a wake-up call. It was a wake-up and get-going call. Joseph had to get away from Herod and from the soldiers who would be coming to kill the little boys. Herod figured if he killed all the little boys age 2 and under, then certainly he would catch Jesus in the mix. Jesus then would never grow up to save his people and never threaten Herod's throne. So Joseph had to leave right away. He took Jesus and Mary and he moved in order to protect his family. He did what he had to do. He went to a new land. He started a new life with his new wife and his new son. And for a second time, Jesus listened to an angel and it changed everything. Tomorrow begins a new year for us, a time when we might be looking at some changes we'd like to make. Resolutions for a new way of living, new habits, you know what they are, eating better, exercising more, praying, reading the Bible more, volunteering more, things like that. One thing is that we always resolve to be better, not worse. That's a good thing. And I actually believe in resolutions. I have seen overweight people start walking and then jogging and then suddenly training for marathons. I've seen people quit smoking and quit drinking and quit cussing and quit yelling at their kids. I know that sometimes we don't follow through, but sometimes we do, and it changes everything. If you were here on Christmas Eve, we heard Joy sing a song. And in the morning, Sophie Hagen did a beautiful sacred dance while Joy sang. Sue and I were talking about it yesterday, and we were both saying we got goosebumps just thinking about that song. It was so beautiful and moving. And I haven't been able to get that song out of my mind since. I keep thinking about how Christmas, how the birth of that little baby boy changes everything. And we can't go through Christmas without being changed. We can't get to know Jesus without everything changing. A baby changes everything. The song was written back in 2008 on Faith Hill's first Christmas album, and it's called A Baby Changes Everything. It was written especially for her voice. It's a beautiful song. The end of it goes like this. I'm not singing. Shepherds all gather round up above the star shines down. A baby changes everything. Choirs of angels sing glory to the newborn king. A baby changes everything. Everything, everything, everything. My whole life has turned around. I was lost, but now I'm found. A baby changes everything. Hallelujah. If you are a mom or a dad or an aunt or an uncle or even friend to children, you know the babies change everything. And if we get it about this baby, if we understand that this baby boy was actually God himself wrapped up in frail flesh to come and be among us in order to show us a different way to live, if we get that, it changes everything. And part of that everything is us. We should be changed by Jesus. And each year at this time, we should look at the ways in which we've allowed ourselves to be changed and the ways in which we've stopped to change, right? Or stood in the way of God's desires for us. As we straddle the old and new year, let's take time to ponder all the things that we've done and maybe not done in 2017. What did 2017 bring us? What do our actions of this past year teach us? What do we need to leave behind us as we move into a new year? Can we let go of our disappointments, our anger, our resentment? We know there's been a lot this year. Can we forgive ourselves and each other for the times that we failed to love and the times that we bruised each other with our careless words or thoughtless deeds? Can we turn over to God all the burdens that weighed us down throughout this past year? As we put up our new calendars, may we commit to bringing our best selves into the new year. And let's make 2018 the year that we lived even more fully into the person that God created us to be and the world needs us to be. May may we feel within us a renewed sense of purpose to carry God's light into the world in each of our own unique ways. As Tia said, let's make love the foundation for all we do and say. It's the only thing that can heal brokenness in our lives and the brokenness in our world. May we bring it into relationships with whom we, into those relationships that we hold fondly, but also into those relationships with those we might consider our enemies. That love is the power through which God makes miracles. Angels are among us and around us. This is the last week for our series, Angels Among Us. And we know that they whisper in our ears, that they invite us into the miracles of life and love. They guide us to places where we're needed, places where we're fed and challenged, places that will lead us to the next place in our journey. We are the unlikely characters that God needs to mend a broken world. We just need to find our way to that little baby by the light of the star and leave a different way. Leave another way, use another route, learn new things, be a different person, knowing that that baby